Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to the Saturday Nine Ball Tournament in the Avalanche Bar and Grill. On the 6th of May 2017. And it's a round robin nine ball match with eight players. And this match features Rob Wright and Peter Sue. The war goes on, as they say, as they continue to battle for dominance to see who gets to control the world. Anyways, Rob gets to win the break. Beautiful, powerful break. The balls are scattered like leaves in the wind. Lots of opportunities there. So there is 9 games total in this match, and for each win you get a point, and at the end of the match you total up how many points you have, and then you play the next player and you try to accumulate as many points as you can. Very nice draw shot. The cue ball goes to the middle of the table. Very fine cut here coming up. And Rob does it like a pro. Beautiful shot. Very shot very hard to get the cue ball to get over there. Amazing shooting. And game number one is a runner for Rob Wright. Peter Sue gets the break. Hooked on the one, he will need to call a push.
Okay, stop. Are you okay?
But Peter's going to try to wreck the layout for Rob, because Rob's going to. so Rob won't be able to run out. So he's gonna shoot the 3 ball into the rail, and Rob will have to bank the one. But Rob will also have to get the cue ball to go down table so he could see the 2 ball. So it's a very complex and difficult shot. Oh, Rob puts the 1 ball in. And Rob has to shoot the 2, which doesn't have a clear pocket, so he goes for a hook. The 9 ball sits ominously over the side pocket, and that bothers Peter. He'd rather not have the 9 there. He thought about shooting the 9 straight in and giving Rob ball in hand, but he's not happy about how the 9 balls is going to be spotted. So he decides to go for to hit the 2, and he totally misses. But fortunately for Peter, Rob is unable to do the 2 ball and 9 combo. Rob Sewers. And Peter gets ball in hand. Peter must get to the six after shooting the five. So the question is how to do it. Peter will just go off the rail, I guess, and get the cue ball back to the middle of the table. He's training himself to get the cue ball to the middle of the table. That shot's not too bad. Peter takes game. This game, the score is now 1-1. We're up to break. Hooks himself on the one ball. I gather Rob's got a push, do a push. And the shot doesn't look too good. I don't think anybody could see the way. So Peter gives it back to Rob. Rob's gonna do a I guess.
Wow, that sucked.
Peter's gonna go for the combo. And fails miserably.
Made it.
Well, maybe not so miserably. Peter got lucky. The nine ball goes to the side pocket. The score is now 1 for Rob, 2 for Peter. Peter to break. Peter needs to get the cue ball to the middle of the table where he can see the two ball. Thankfully, Peter didn't shoot that hard, just enough to get to the middle of the table, because any harder he would have hooked himself on the two. Nice clean open table. Peter should be able to run out. Peter needs to do a bottom right. It's almost a straight shot. He'll have to cheat the pocket a bit. He'll try to go off the rail. Nope, he didn't go off the rail. The shot just drew straight back. And Peter sued in the shot. Quite a big surprise, actually. He didn't expect the cue ball to go back that far. Rob uses the rails very nicely. Rob knows his trajectories and keeps the cue ball off the rail and near the center of the table after every shot. Very nice shooting. Rob has now 2 points in 2 games. Rob to go.
Who's second?
Well, looks like a 9-ball combo is coming up.
Give me all the games and I'll get there.
Can't do that.
Oh, maybe he's going for the 5-ball. I can't tell. Yeah, he could be the going for the 5. Yes, he was. I thought he was going for the 9. I thought maybe he'd be better off trying for the 9. Peter is hooked on the 1. Lucky shot. Clear open table. Can Peter run out from here? Well, the cue ball didn't end up at a good spot. Peter is definitely offline now. Cue ball is on the rail, making it very difficult to pot this ball with any amount of control. Peter totally misses, but does he get lucky? No, he does not. The cue ball peeks out from the 5. Well, but Rob hooks himself on the 5-ball. And Rob gives Peter another clear open table for an easy run out. Peter gets into trouble. Normally he will do an inside top to get the cue ball to the middle of the table, but for some reason he decides to do a stun shot, a stop shot, which absolutely just dies on the rail. And Peter has to shoot off the rail, which is his big weakness, and he misses.
Oh, shit.
Ooh. Game could have been yours, buddy. How did you mess up like that? Next time, inside top. Rob now has 3 points to Peter's 2. Peter to break. Hooked on the 1. Peter's going to try to cross bank the 1 into the corner.
I'm 45 minutes away. I'm waiting to get something in my house. It's locked.
There's nothing much else he can do. Whoops. The Now the one ball collides with the cue ball.
Yeah, the smash, it's not worth it. You gotta make sure you protect yourself. And just make sure. Baby.
Very nice cue ball control. Whoops. Rob under hit that shot. Didn't come near to the middle of the table as he usually gets the cue ball to go. Rob is very deadly, even long distance. Although in this shot, he doesn't have an angle to get the five in the corner. I'm just assuming Rob was trying to go for a hook there. And the cue ball is right by the rail. Peter will need to put bottom on this one or else he will definitely sewer on the five. The cue ball will end up in the middle pocket. So Peter's gonna draw. Nicely done. Very difficult shot. Peter will have to put inside on this one. Soft inside. He does not want the cue ball to run away. The cue ball must die after it hits the rail. Peter now has three games, as does Rob. There's only three games left in the set. Nothing Peter can do about the one ball. He's gonna go for a hook. Peter's gonna go for a hook. There's no way Rob can hit the one ball. So Rob's going to mess up the table for Peter. He's gonna give Peter a ball in hand, but he's gonna knock the three ball into the dead spot using the corner. Naturally that's a foul, but he's gonna put Peter in a position where having ball in hand won't do much for him. Very nice shot. The three ball is now in the dead zone, where Peter really dislikes having the object ball. Now, the trick right now is to get the cue ball in position so when he shoots the two in, he will also break out the three.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So the three ball is a big problem for Peter right now. So Peter's going to decide to draw into the one ball, but first he considers going off the rail first. But he'll go for the draw. This is a tricky shot because he can overdraw and lose position, and he does. He's lost the breakout angle. And the only shot he has is to the corner. And so what Peter's going to do is do a deep draw and try to kick the three ball out. Yeah. Quite nicely done. Peter will need to get position on the four ball after shooting the three. And three ball doesn't go in. I think Rob undershot because he doesn't. He's lost the angle. Rob's going to go for a hook. Very nicely done. Peter is going to go off the rail. But in order to cut down the angle, Peter's going to put a lot of inside. Actually, in retrospect, outside English would have been better because the problem is the inside kept the cue ball from going out, and Peter Sue is outside would have given him a chance to hit the four. Or is that the three? That was the three. Oh, that was the three. Sorry. Okay, easy run out table for Rob. And he does it like a pro.
Oh, maybe too hard.
Very nice cue ball control. Rob now has four games after taking
Where are we at now, Pete?
I thought you didn't smoke, but then maybe
we have two games left in the match. Very nice break by Peter. Open table.
Smart, like,
there's no reason why he can't run out. He needs to bring the cue ball back to the middle of the table. So he will have to either go off the rail, the top rail, or go back. And Peter's going to go off the top rail because his long distance draws aren't that good.
Yeah,
yeah, for sure. Once you raise your head. The shot is almost straight in. Peter's gonna go up the five into the rail. It almost missed.
Thanks. I missed that one.
Rob concedes again, much to Peter's relief, because sometimes Peter misses those shots, even though they're easy. Rob to break. This is the final game in the match. Beautiful shot.
Beautiful shot.
They're on the side, supposed to be over here.
Yeah,
that was good.
That was good.
Yeah, that was good.
Oh my god.
Uh-oh.
Rob managed to sewer on that shot. Easy run out table for Peter. Can Peter do it?
Oh.
Peter was about to shoot the seven ball. Rob reminded him that the six is still there. Okay, this is a tricky situation. Peter needs to keep a little angle after shooting the six. In retrospect, Peter should have just shot forward instead of drawing it back. Peter decides to draw back. And he overdrew. So, shall he shoot for the side pocket or the corner? The side pocket is easy, but it'll be difficult for him to get position on the nine. So he's going to go for the corner. And misses.
That was the pro way. That's what they say. Pro way is the corner.
Rob's not going to miss this one.
I should have went for the side.
Peter will have to work on his drawers. His drawers tend to go out of his control. Well, Rob has 5 points. Peter has 4.
5-4.
Later, Rob gets to win. Is the number of points makes him the number one, and Marianne gets number two spot. Terrific tournament by Darlene Mercer, and thank you everybody for a terrific Saturday.